I just got done sanding this ash body for the next telly. Look at that wood grain. You can see how dark and deep this is, and then the top grain in here, it's much lighter. This is gonna be perfect for the Ceruse coat that I'm doing on this. Be able to see two really distinct different types of color. Definitely something that I'm gonna look into doing more and more in the future too, so. Like even that, look at the little ripple, like kind of like a flame maple or quilted maple. Get a lot of cool grain in here. Took me a couple hours to hand sand this. The company that we bought it from used an orbital. And when you do that, sometimes it leaves like little squigglies all over the guitar. And that's what I had to kind of hand sand out. So right now it's sanded to 320, which feels pretty good. It should be perfect for that Ceruse coat. All right, so next we're going to apply the Rubio Monocoat Precolor. We're going with intense black on this first coat. It says to mix it well, wear gloves. First we're gonna use a brush it into the grain, and then we're going to use a sponge and rub it into the grain. So we'll do that next. All right, and then after we use the brush, we need to use a sponge. We need a sanding sponge, any kind of sponge really. Work that into the grain. All right, now let's sit for about 10 minutes. All right, so it's been about 10 minutes. Time to wipe it off, wipe off all the excess, get it kind of dry, rub it into the grain still again. I like to use old t-shirts, or you can use just whatever common kind of cotton cloth. So make sure that's not leaving behind a whole lot of fuzz. That's why I use old t-shirts. You won't get like lint stuck into the pores of the wood and the grain. All right, so it's been a little over 2 hours. Let's see where it's at now. Nice kind of flat black. It's got decent sheen to it. Probably we'll end up building some guitars and finishing them just like this because I like that flat black, satin black kind of look. But the next is the second part, the oil plus. So I'm gonna do like a silver gray. Make sure you get the accelerator, otherwise it can take a really long time. 2 to 1, so 2 parts, 1 part. I'm gonna measure it out with the scale. I'm just gonna end up using all of it. It was a sample. First time using this one, so I just want to make sure that it's all good and I get it all. And I'm a little worried that it's not even going to be enough to do the whole guitar, but we will see. So about 3/4 of an ounce, about 2 to 1 there. Stir it up real nice. Yeah, I'm definitely a little worried about this covering, but won't know till we get there. All right, so we got the gloves back on. I'm gonna go back to the brush. I know other places showed online using the sponge and everything, but I want to apply it kind of, since I don't have a whole lot, I just want to make sure that I'm kind of in control of how much is going on here. Just push it in. Make sure it goes into that deep grain, you'll see it. That's the main thing that's important, is getting it into that, those little ridges in there.
wipe it off. Look at that. That is gorgeous. Oh yeah. All right. So now we gotta finish up, do the rest.
And there you have it. Ceruse ash body, black pre-coat, silver gray, top coat fill in that grain. Gorgeous. Like, this thing is so beautiful. Oh, I can't wait to do more of these.